In celebration of Pride Month, here are my top 5 queer Power Rangers headcanon that I think I have pretty good evidence to back up. Number 5, Rito Revolto. Rito is clearly gay, by which of course I mean he's always in a good mood and very merry, and obviously has a crush on Goldar. I mean, he takes it upon himself to follow Goldar everywhere, and he gives him the cute little nickname Goldie, and no matter how mean Goldar is to him, he just keeps tagging along after him with those big puppy dog eyes. And shit gets real domestic between them. I mean, they're basically an old married couple at this point. I'm just sad that Goldar never reciprocated, because I think they would have made a genuinely cute couple. Number 4. You know it, you love it, my ship of Bestro. Due to the lack of chemistry, Sestri is obviously a beard there to give Billy an excuse to move to Aquitar to be with Sestro. If you've watched the Mighty Morphing Alien Rangers, then you've seen the same romance develop that I've seen. And no matter how many times the Aquitarians leave Earth, Sestro just keeps coming back for Billy until he finally moves to Aquitar with him. Number 3, the romance in Time Force is a love triangle. I've talked about the Power Rangers' strict no cooties law before that states since Tommy and Kimberly broke up, there will be no kissing. But they have found a replacement for it, and that's the passionate embrace, the rules of which state that this is a kiss, and this is a kiss. I mean, Trip like Wes right away. The first real conversation they have just is the balcony scene from Romeo and Juliet. And throughout the show, as Wes is continually rejected by Jin, he falls into the arms of Trip, who's interested in his interests and is very loving and supporting towards him. It's a classic love triangle, where Wes has to make a decision between an emotionally mature and supportive lover or the passionate romance. And of course, we all see that he picks the passionate romance, but that doesn't mean that the love triangle wasn't there.
Number 2.
Kelsey Winslow. I would be shocked if she was not written with the intention of being a lesbian. I mean, she's into rock climbing, she's always wearing exercise clothes, she doesn't care about hair or makeup, she has that incredibly flirtatious episode with the astronaut, which implies that all of her teammates know that she's a lesbian because they're like, oh look, it's Kelsey's friend on TV. Plus her whole friendship with Chad, where she tells him she's gonna teach him how to pick up chicks because she knows how to pick up chicks. Number 1. Riley Griffin is gay. Eternal thanks to Michael Tabor for saying in an interview that he played the character to be gay. What a way for an actor to hijack the show. Because no matter what the writers intended, he's the one playing the character, so his intention actually makes a difference. I mean, Riley Griffin is gay, and he has a crush on Chase. It's too bad that Chase is a serial heterosexual and never notices, but he and Zinnowing definitely have a thing. And I do not need to rationalize this to you. Just look at it.